Performance Horse Arena. We'll be heading back to Goodyear, Arizona for the winter. We will be leaving first part of January 2015. And again, this year we'll be working out of the Estrella Mountain Regional Park. We'll be in partnerships once again with Corral West Horse Adventures. If you guys are down, want to go for a trail ride, come and check these folks out. We'll be working in the old rodeo grounds again this year. It works out really good for us down there. It's got good footing. It's got lights, lots of parking. The rodeo grounds was established back in the early 80s. In the background there, you can see the grandstands. They have a great sound system. Our main goal this year is to try to get the rodeo grounds up and running again. Get the local community to come out and the snowbirders as well, and take advantage of this great facility that is there. Here, for instance, we're showing a clinic that we did for ranch sorting last year. And first half of the clinic is working on your horsemanship. Once we have the confidence built in the rider, we take the horse and we actually get the horse and rider to hook up with a cow. Then at the end of the clinic, you'll be working like this gal here. We'll actually be doing a real ranch sorting competition. This is a real popular thing for most folks. I also work with Corral West with the kid program that they offer, and we really enjoy working with kids. We also are going to have roping clinics and lessons. I work with groups or private individuals. Like right here, I'm working with a couple kids. They never picked a rope up before. Like a lot of you know, I have been teaching individuals for 25 years. I've taught a lot of people how to pick up a rope and be able to walk away, knowing how to swing a rope correctly and being able to ride a horse. Roping is a real exciting, exhilarating event. It's a great sport, but you do have five separate minds in this sport. You have two riders, two horses, and a steer coming out of the chute. And so we have to literally slow things down and start working on one thing at a time. Those guys that are out there and they're catching all the time and they're winning all the time, a real huge part of it is horsemanship. All of the horses that I ride and train on, they're all well-rounded. I head and heel on all of the horses. I work them on the outside of the arena as well as the inside of the arena. I work a lot on the box. Your run immediately starts from the box. If you're not set up correctly, the rest of your run isn't going to work out the way that you plan it to be. Now this year we're bringing Smarty down. So on Tuesday nights, we plan on turning on the lights, pulling Smarty around. Now this is really, really good tool for working on your horse as well as working on you. For instance, right here I'm riding a colt, and when you're able to take a colt, slow things down, make him stay over, make him stay in the lane they need to be, then ask him to go left with control. You're able to advance your horsemanship and get your horse working a whole lot better. And with this drag dummy, you can break things down. You can be very meticulous in what you're working on. It's the same pattern, same speed. It's very difficult to get that out of a live steer. We do a lot with Smarty. I could teach the head horse or I could teach a heel horse. Now also at the rodeo grounds, we're going to be offering horsemanship and trail class. That'll be on Wednesday nights at 7 o'clock. We also will be doing private lessons or group lessons. But in this class, what we work on is hooking up with your horse. That is the first thing you have to do. And I believe to hook up with your horse, you need to be able to work them on the ground. We go around barrels, we go over cavalettis, we go across the old blue tarp. We introduce them to paper sacks and balls and all kinds of stuff. Pretty much anything and everything you could think of to throw at them, that's what we do. I am a firm believer in using visual aid. And if you can get a horse to start working around barrels or around poles, certain objects, it helps them realize how to bend and arc their body. All of my horses that I train and the individuals that I teach, I get them to get their horses to be able to do anything. And you do that because they become a willing partner. They listen to you. You are the parent, you are the coach, you are the leader of the team. But the horse becomes a willing individual. And you gain that by confidence. You gain it with respect. Now here what we're showing is some of the trails. Estrella Mountain Regional Park is just under 20,000 acres. Estrella Park has some really great trails. I mean literally miles and miles of trails to ride on. I take all my horses and my outside horses as well as all my students. We throw saddles on and we get outside the arena. I really believe that it's good to work in the arena, but it's also really great on the minds of the horse and the people to get them outside and go enjoy a trail ride. Now on Saturday, January 24th, we plan on holding the clinic. We'll be working in the arena, on horsemanship, obstacles in the arena, and then we'll be getting out on the trails. Well, we hope to see you guys at the old rodeo grounds. You guys take care and ride safe.